Well, 24 hours into free agency and the Flames have definitely made a splash. The latest on defense with Chris Tanev joining the team on a four-year deal. And Chris, I'm sure it was a busy day for you with negotiations going well into the evening last night. How did the day play out for you and what made Calgary the right fit?
Yeah, so obviously a lot of ups and downs throughout the day. It's definitely tough leaving Vancouver after I've been there for a third of my life, basically, and played there for quite some time now. But it was, I think, as the day progressed, Calgary initially showed a lot of interest in me, and as the day progressed, that sort of heated up a bit and ended up signing, obviously, towards the end of the night.
So I was going to say, I mean, you were fourth in the NHL in block shots last year. So maybe the happiest person of all is actually your former Vancouver teammate, Jacob Markstrom, that you're joining the club. He signed a six-year deal with the Flames earlier on yesterday. Did you get a chance to chat with him at all over the last 24 hours?
Yeah, we've talked a couple times, actually. So, I mean, obviously it's tough with the time change a little bit, but he's in Sweden. But we've chatted three or four times, and we're obviously both excited to continue playing together. We've done so the past 5 or 6 years, and it's he's a great goalie. He's a hell of a person, and he's going to be a great player for Calgary and us going forward. So I'm super excited to be able to play with him.
So, Chris, you're obviously known for your defense and your shot-blocking ability, among other things, of course. But, you know, for those on the outside who maybe haven't seen you as much, how would you describe your game, and what do you kind of envision your role being here with the Flames?
Yeah, I mean, as you said, I feel like I skate well. I can move the puck. I break the puck out. Break the puck out well. I penalty kill, block shots, definitely play a bit more of a defensive role, but I mean, I can get up the ice and contribute if need be. But I'm happy to join the team, and we'll see what role I take going forward. But I mean, it's going to be a fun transition into playing with Calgary here.
You mentioned it, 10 seasons in Vancouver. That's a significant portion of your life. But you're certainly no stranger to the Flames and the Pacific Division battles. What have you seen out of this team over the past year, especially as both teams have kind of gone in certain directions? And what do you think it's going to be like playing on the other side of that rivalry?
Yeah, I mean, as you said, I've played Calgary. Obviously, one of the most teams I've played against in my career. And it's always hard playing them. A lot of skill, a lot of speed, and they play fast. So I mean, it's good to be a part of that. And obviously now going against and playing Vancouver, it's going to be a little bit different. Obviously, after being there for so long, but Vancouver's got a really, really good young skilled team, and they play fast, and they're going to be good. Going into the future as well. They have a lot of really, really good players.
I know things looked and probably felt a little bit different than you're used to, but a deep playoff run for you guys, 17 games in all. I mean, on a personal note, you know, after going a couple of years without being in the postseason, what did that experience do for you personally?
Yeah, it's huge just to get back into playoffs, and that's the funnest time of the year. Every game, every play, every second means something. So, I mean, the ability to play in those meaningful games is huge after you haven't done so in quite some time.
I've got to ask, though, on that note, your goal to win the series against Minnesota, just take me through the emotions of getting one like that, especially on that stage.
Yeah, it's any goal in playoffs are big, especially coming from the D-men. But, I mean, it's in overtime, and it's just it was a very – joyful time for our team, obviously getting past Minnesota and moving on to play against St. Louis. A lot of emotion, a lot of energy, and it was definitely a good run that we had in Vancouver this year.
So as it stands here, there's a lot of young but really talented players on the Calgary blue line, Rasmus Anderson, Yusuf Alimaki, Oliver Shillington, all guys that are likely to take on a bit bigger of a role this year. You played pretty much the entire season on a pair with Quinn Hughes last year and really helped him along as a rookie. I mean, is that something you really pride yourself on as a veteran guy being a mentor to your younger teammates?
Yeah, I definitely want to help the younger guys adjust to the league and be comfortable on the ice, on and off the ice. Sorry, but it's something that I definitely embrace and try to accomplish, and hopefully I did that with Quinn. I know we built a great relationship and had great chemistry on and off the ice. So hopefully I can do that as I join Calgary here.
Awesome. And just last one for you, Chris, again, different than usual, but how's the off season going for you and what have you been up to?
Yeah, it's a bit of a different time. You're never home during the fall usually. So, I mean, the leaves are changing and it's getting colder and that's usually when hockey time starts. But I'm in Toronto and it's just been getting back into the gym and I've golfed a little bit and trying to enjoy the weather before it starts to get a bit colder here.
You betcha. Great stuff, Chris. Thank you so much for your time, man. Congratulations on the new deal. Welcome to Calgary. I look forward to meeting you in person and getting this season underway.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.